Hello and welcome to Windows, a History. To truly know Windows, to actually learn it, I feel like you should know the history, where it came from, the humble beginnings. So here we go, this will be very, very brief, a brief history. Now our journey begins not with Windows, but before Windows MS-DOS. 1981, this was Microsoft DOS, and this was before the GUI or the graphical user interface that we use now, the pretty stuff. I don't know why I just did this. Now there's a fun website you can go to right now, it'll be in the description, but you can actually try this yourself. So let me find it. MS-DOS, there it is. Let's boot it up. MS-DOS 6.22, the latest and greatest. Now, all you really have to know about MS-DOS is that it's command line only, meaning our ancestors and people before us only used command line. That's how you compute it. And it's actually having me install this, which is fascinating. Like, there they are, the exact version we're playing with, Microsoft DOS 6.22 in Spanish. Hola. But you would need three of those bad boys, loading them up into your computer, trading them out to install this. Then you go find 6.22 disk 2, load, enter. This is kind of fun, actually. Disk 3, I'm in this now. I have to finish it. Ah, it's done. I gotta remove all the floppy drives. I don't know how to remove them. It's installed. Oh, there we go. Starting MS-DOS. And all that work for this. Okay, we're gonna move a bit faster now. Microsoft realized people like seeing things and clicking things, so they created Microsoft Windows 1.0 in 1985. Let's try it out. Windows 1.04. We'll do Windows 1.0. For the first time ever, people could click things and launch really fun stuff like the clock program. Woo! It wasn't much, but it's what they had. It was a big hit. Windows 2.0 was launched in 87, but the one people care about is Windows 3.0 and 3.1 in 1990 and 1992. This is where things really started cooking, because now, let me show you this thing. Look at this. This is a huge upgrade. Control panel, which we'll talk more about later. It looks a lot better now. I don't know, this looks pretty cool. They had virtual memory in this version, and the ultimate thing they have now, games. Solitaire, are you kidding me? Productivity tanked. People just stopped working. Then in 1995, the first computer I ever used was born. Windows 95. They started naming it after the year, which is nice. Don't get used to it. And let's go boot it up. This looks so much more like the Windows we use today. Now, it does look old. So, yes, I'm old. But look at this. Oh, my dad and I built this computer. It was my first computer, and I remember playing Red Alert on this. Oh, good memories, good times. And here it is. Notice we have our start button. It looks amazing. And it pretty much looks like what we have now. Man, the memories on this. Woo! Now, after this, things started to speed up. In 1998, Windows 98 came out. Better USB support, some cool things, that's all you gotta know about. Then in the year 2000, the millennium, weird things happened. Windows ME, or Millennium Edition, came out. It was terrible, but it was definitely prettier. Also, Windows 2000 came out. This was awesome. This was for the workplace, mainly. But then in 2001, something amazing happened. The best Windows version, in my opinion, ever came out. Windows XP. This version was amazing. Wanna see it? I had to spin this up on my own computer. Because it was my favorite. Now I want you to listen to the sound. It's amazing. Okay, the remix version. Windows XP is pretty. And this is the version that people used for a long time. Mainly because it had pinball. But seriously, people loved it. Businesses loved it. It's the first OS I actually worked with in a real job. I was on the help desk and I supported this OS. Businesses did not want to leave it. And everything was great until 2006. And Windows Vista came out, no one liked this one. It was pretty, but it was bad. Buggy, it crashed all the time, people didn't like it. But then Microsoft made up for it in 2009. Windows 7 came out. And notice we abandoned our yearly naming scheme a long time ago. My 7 looks so weird. It looks weirder now. I don't know what to do. Windows 7 was actually really stable, amazing. It's the first OS people trusted after XP. So actually, in my business I worked with, we had a huge migration of migrating people off of XP to Windows 7. Now, why we do that? Because Microsoft said, you know that Windows XP thing we made that you all love? We're not gonna support it anymore. So no more security updates, no more cool features. We're gonna devote all of that to Windows 7, so you guys may want to move. So we did it. And people were scared. People were freaking out. Ah! Then Microsoft screwed up again in 2000. What year was that? Oh, 2012. That was a weird year. They came out with Windows 8. It was built for tablets. They did away with the start bar. And that was a bad move. So they brought it back in 2013 with Windows 8.1. And then the next best decision Microsoft made, and I'm running out of room here, this was 2015. Wow. And we had Windows 10. This was supposed to be the last Windows edition. They weren't gonna make any more editions. They're just gonna keep upgrading Windows 10 and make it more amazing. But now, we're at Windows 11. They lied. What year was that? I mean, it was just like last year, right? 2021, we have Windows 11. It's what we're using now. And where we've come now is that things are working pretty great. They look good. They're pretty stable, and Microsoft is constantly releasing updates to make sure Windows is secure. It's not always secure. That's why we're having to constantly receive updates. But that's Windows history, where we came from, how we got here. And it's Windows 11 and all the later additions, including servers, which are on Windows Server 2022 now. It's those things we're gonna focus on, zero in on, and learn. But what's fun is you'll notice the concepts we're gonna learn in this course have applied to Windows versions for a while. There'll be a few things that are new, but we're gonna learn the foundation that will hopefully last through the next 15 Windows versions. That's about it. That was Windows history. I'll see you in the next episode.
You made it to the end of the video. If you wanna see the rest of Windows Fundamentals and more great courses like it, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.